you just feel that drag, that exhaustion from deep in your core. It's very hard to describe, but it's just kind of creeps up on you. It's like this dark cloud, and it's like you're living in a fog.
It's like a light, a lamp, and you just pull the plug out, and it's, and you just crash, and it's, you feel like you're just stuck. I spent many years feeling like I was stuck.
I don't know, it feels like you're heavy, like there's just like so much holding you back, and you can't bring yourself to do anything. And like the sadness comes like occasionally, but it's not like weeping all the time. It's more like just like unable to do day-to-day things and stuff like that. I don't know. It's kind of, that question's kind of like trying to explain colors to a blind person, I find.
I think that's one of the biggest problems that people face with depression of any degree, is that your career doesn't suffer nearly as much as your home life does and your social life does, because you have to suck it up, and you have to get through, and you have to manage your responsibilities. I've been lucky in that I've been able to do that. With my daughters, the isolation's there at times, for sure. It had been over the years. But because they're my daughters, it's, unfortunately, sometimes maybe a little less patient than I wanted to be. Sometimes a little less there for them. But there's always energy for kids. Kids are, that's what kept me going with my daughters. I'll go slow because this is the hard part. When I got to that point, it was my daughters that kept me going. And that's the one, they're the one constant in my life that,
who wants to be on TV?
Like right after I had him, I felt unattached from him. Like I didn't. Like, I could see him there, and he was nice, but I didn't quite feel that, like, love at first sight thing that I had read about before. And, like, actually, at one point, I thought about giving him up for adoption, just because I didn't feel like I could do it. So that was just in the first, like, couple days.
T-shirts, do love that.
You know, just on that, I actually feel very, very lucky in retrospect that I had those miscarriages that I had, you know, whether it was postpartum, you know, exactly that, or if it was sort of a broader type of depression. But whatever it was that I experienced that before Lucy was born, because by the time she was born, I was probably 90% better.
Certainly, it was, as I said, for what we noticed was the abruptness in a behavior. All of a sudden, you know, she would get up and get either angry or something like that wasn't normal. Yeah.
There's an example of one Christmas when there was a big family event, and I really had a terrible time at that, and I couldn't be at the event, and I left, and it wasn't a nice scene. And one of the sisters-in-law was yelling at me, you know, you've ruined our Christmas and you should apologize. And you know, while I can understand the sentiment, it's hard when it's like saying, if you've got cancer and you happen to have been going through chemo at Christmas time, that you should apologize for ruining people's Christmas.
One day, she just moved in, and which was good because she felt that this was a good environment for her, was secure or comfortable, and so. But it was kind of unexpected because she arrived, and we were concerned, obviously, and but we knew that she was. You know, she was seeing medical assistance, and so that was the key for us, because from my own past experience, that was the hardest thing was for the person to understand that there is a problem, accept it, and deal with it.
We all have bad days. Right, we all have days that we're down. When we're looking at depression, it is, or especially like diagnosis of clinical depression, is that it's very long term, right? So if someone's had a bad day for more than 2 weeks in a row, we would start to look at, is this more than a situational depression issue?
I think people think that like depression means you cut, the cutting thing or whatever, and I don't do that. That kind of stuff, and maybe that they're crazy, because I'm not crazy, I don't think.
Conversation I had with a friend in business, and we're talking about mental illness, and he says, yeah, and you know what bugs me? He says, they just let those people walk around out there. Yeah, we walk around, we're successful in business, we have families, we have friends. It's not those people, it's people like you and I.
I was in bed, I was lying in bed, the curtains closed, the cover, sleeping, and he was just really frustrated because he couldn't understand what it meant to be depressed. And I wanted to get out so bad, and I was huddled in a corner, up against a wall, like just curled up in a ball, sobbing, and I walked over, and checked the window and how the window slid and how the screen was going to work. And you know, I looked out and I thought, yeah, well, like if I push this way and I sort of crawl out and I hang from my fingers, it's probably only, you know, a 20-foot drop, right? And then it's like, oh, you know, something made me not do it. Probably I wouldn't have died from dropping out of a window that high. I doubt it. Maybe I would have twisted an ankle or something, but you're doing stupid things, right? Like nobody crawls out of a window.
Got to a point in my life, I remember driving home in the dark one night and just thinking, what's the point? You know, all I do is work. I work, I eat, I sleep, and I wasn't spending enough time with my kids. Yeah, things were just so completely out of balance. And then I found myself a day or two later weighing the amount of life insurance and equity I had against the amount of debt that I was carrying. So in my mind, wondering if I didn't make it through, what would my family be left with?
I remember one night I was doing coke and with like some people, and my boyfriend at the time was dealing ecstasy, so we started taking those, and I felt really good, like really happy on the ecstasy, so I kept taking them and taking them, and then I took 24 and I overdosed and I was having seizures and stuff, and I didn't go to the hospital because I was too scared. But yeah, I just like stayed awake for 3 days, and I don't know, I just was like screwed up. And then like after that, like I never did chemicals again, but I missed that happy feeling that I was on the ecstasy. And yeah, I don't know, I remember thinking about suicide a lot after that. Like I was never really right again after that.
I did admit myself to the hospital once while I was actually pregnant with Lucy, because I felt that I was at risk. I hadn't an actual plan to commit suicide, but I was having suicidal thoughts. That had happened more than once, mostly when I was around other people. I have a very close friend who had severe anxiety disorder and had attempted suicide twice. My stepfather's first wife had was bipolar, and she took her own life.
There was help, but she never accepted it at the end. And she just decided, I think she decided she wasn't going to do that. That wasn't, for whatever reason, she basically didn't want to live that life, I guess, that way. Yeah.
And this is really where your outside world really needs to break in and help out. When someone's in a really severe depression, it's very difficult for them to self-motivate. That's where it's very important that person is also working very closely with their doctor to discuss what kind of medications. A lot of times at that place, your brain is very foggy, and sometimes the medication can just help your brain to have more clarification.
The hardest step is the first step, and that's asking for help. And it's not that you're not normal if you struggle a little bit. Everybody does to some degree at some point in their life. I think everybody does.
Well, the first thing was to go to the doctor. That was something that, in retrospect, again, was, thank God I did, and thank God I did when I did. He got me in touch with a psychiatrist, so I started counseling with a psychiatrist. And then just the medication. So having, trying different types of medication, trying to find the one that was going to work for me, the right dosage.
When I was first diagnosed, I got Effexor for it. And yeah, that never actually really helped. So, but I, like for help, I guess I was going to AA meetings and stuff like that, just like therapy with the people at the rehab.
We would never think of managing our own diabetes without the help of professionals. We would never think of managing, you know, heart disease without the help of professionals. But when it comes to mental health, we think we need to keep it hidden, or we think, I can cope with this. I shouldn't need anybody else to help me. I can get over this. If I just think positively, I can get over this. Or if I just read another book, I can get over this. And what we really need to, the message that we really need to get out there is that there's lots of great help out there, but you have to ask for it.
Right now I feel pretty good, and like I still get sad, obviously, like I'm a human, but like it's like, I don't know, I feel like it won't really affect my life too much. Or I hope it won't, anyways.
What do you do? You're so crazy.
You know, instead of, you know, the sky's the limit, well, I don't want the sky. I don't want everything. I don't want to live out of a suitcase. I don't want to be a workaholic, and I don't want to lose the, you know, the important relationships that I have in my life.
Yeah, life today is a lot different than it was. Number one, I have an 8-year-old now. And I'll be 50 instead of 40. So that just gives you a whole different perspective on life too. Things don't seem as urgent or as important or as stressful or as chaotic for me at this point. And don't get so bogged down in, oh my gosh, I'm gonna be away from work for 2 whole weeks. Is the world gonna come to an end? Well, no, it's not. I'll keep going just fine. Thank you very much.
So yeah, what I usually like to do is just get somewhere natural, usually a river. I'll deal with a certain amount of challenge, so you can carry it or you can let it go. I tend to I like letting it go at the river.